दाने द्रव्याणी बाय चैरिटी बाय गिविंग चैरिटी वन्स पोजेशंस गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड. वट एवर दे पोजेशंस दे हैव मेटीरियल पोजेशंस दैट गेट्स प्यूरिफाइड. सो देयर फॉर जस्ट लाइक यू सी हियर नंद महाराज इज गिविंग चैरिटी. When someone gives charity, that possessions gets purified. So in this context, one has to understand that how much, to whom, and which place. There are descriptions in the shastras. But at least we hear from Rupa Goswami's description. Prabhupada writes in Chaitanya Charitamrita purport also. How Rupa Goswami divided his savings, and then 50% is for iskand. I'm not brahmanas and brahmins, and 25% is for emergency, and 25% for his family members, like that. So in this way, one should know the art, especially those who are family men. How much should give charity? And how the savings can be divided in a proper ratio to use to serve everyone. In this context, I just want to quote one verse from 8th canto, 19th chapter, Bali Maharaj section, and that is such a wonderful verse, text 37, 8:19-37. This verse describes the financial management for a devotee. Interesting, no? You don't have to go to outside to get some tips from the so-called books or so-called motivational speakers to get some financial management. Everything is there in our Vedic literature. Shukracharya says to Bali Maharaj, there is one thing is called Suddha Bhakti, which demands everything, surrender everything. Manasa deho geho joki sumara arpilu tuya pade samu sundara. Everything you give. But there is also some practicality. And how much and when, to whom one can give. Especially those who are families, men, grihasthas, they can learn this art from Shastras. How they can have this financial management. All the savings can be divided into 5 parts, and this can be used in various purposes. Shukracharya says, first, remember, dharmaya, everyone from his income or savings, at least 10% of his savings or income should exclusively used for the donation, for charity, for dharmaya, for religious purpose, especially for spiritual activity like charity to Hari, Guru and Vaishnavas. In a temple community like Pune, when I was there is thousands of congregations and thousands of youth, and there is a very nice system I was very much inspired that in the community, all the congregation members, those who are earning, and the youths also, those who are earning, they give at least 10% of their income to the temple. By some Nitya Seva, that Seva, this Seva. And by this, the temple is run, and even the ISKCON NBCC Pune temple has been built by all the united effort of the congregation member. Just see. So, this is a very good art, how we can contribute to society, contribute to the local temple in a community. So therefore it is called dharmaya. 10% of the, at least I am saying, at least 25-50%, Rupa Goswami did 50%. He gave it. 10% at least we can save just for the Hari Guru Vaishnava Seva. First is dharmaya. Listen, financial management. Second one, yasase. Some of the savings can be used for yasa, to get the fame. Although devotee doesn't want in return, But still, the name is announced, the Yasa is also spread. Yasa means what? Some for betterment of society. What kind of? Like, devotional social activity. Devotional. It is a very interesting new thing. How? By contributing book distribution, medication, gaushala, opening library, book library, construction of the temple, medication, for education. We have so many education centers who teaches Bhakti Shastri, Bhakti Vaibhava. So, and some of them, they give free education to the brahmacharis. And to such some contribution, because that is for yasa. You see, devotees, they give donation, they do seva, and they get, even though they don't want, they get that credit. In the temple hall, you see the name of the devotees here in the right, here also, when the Krishna Balaram temple was opened, the names are, there will be forever, like this devotee also, Lakshminarayana. So there should be some contribution for yasa, food for life, dham seva, dham vasi seva, anything we can contribute. This is second one, yasa se. Third one is arthaya. What is the meaning of arthaya? The money can produce more money. Okay? So a family man, a grihastha, can save, invest some money for economic growth, like some insurances, some savings, some business, whatever they do. Why? For economic growth, for the growth of economy, and so that they can do more seva. For that also they can save. Fourth one, kamaya, he says, fulfilling the desires. To live in this world, we have so many desires. At least basic necessities. I want a house to live in. My wife, my children are there. What about them? What about their career? What about their education? What about their futures? There should be some savings. Therefore, that is called kamaya. And sometimes the recreations, going, visiting Vrindavan, Mayapur, yatra, festivals, we go. That is also there. So this all comes in the category of kamaya. And lastly, he said, swajanaya. Swajanaya means, he says, for families, for own families and relatives. Some savings should be for wife and children, for my parents, for in-laws, and so many things. In social obligations, there should be some savings. So in this way, one can divide his economy into 5 parts. And then, at last, Shukracharya said that, in this way, you can live peacefully in this world, ultimately get the liberation.